A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 30th November, Saturday, on the front page you have New Delhi announces $450 million to Colombo. So, Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa is on a visit to India. It is his first state visit after being sworn in as president. And in India, Indian government has now announced $450 million package. So Sri Lanka will get $50 million to fight terror threats. So this is, and $400 million is line of credit that India has announced for infrastructure development in Sri Lanka. So China also has significant presence in Sri Lanka, and India to ensure its strategic interest is also wooing Sri Lanka. Then here you have GDP growth plunges to 4.5%, lowest since 2012. So this is regarding GDP growth. You can see for the quarter from July to September has hit 25 quarter low. It is at 4.5%. You can see the graph dipping here. Officials say fundamentals are strong, numbers will pick up. Below you have FASTag deadline extended. So government has extended till December 15 the deadline for making FASTag mandatory for toll payments on national highways. Earlier, all lanes except one on each side at all National Highway Authority of India toll plazas were to be declared as dedicated FASTag lanes from December 1. But now NHAI has made a statement that citizens have not enabled their vehicles with FASTags due to which the decision has been deferred till December 15. And this is regarding Godse remark by Pragya Singh Thakur. She has offered apology twice. She has read out a written statement also offering an apology after her statement in parliament in which she called Nathuram Godse, Mahatma Gandhi's assassin, as a Deshbhakt. On page 4 you have Supreme Court accepts SIT report on 1984 anti-Sikh riots. So Supreme Court has taken on record a confidential probe report filed by special investigation team SIT on 186 cases of 1984 anti-Sikh riots. So this SIT has been chaired by former Delhi High Court Judge S.N. Dhingra, and it was set up by the Supreme Court in January 2018 to investigate in those cases which were closed by an earlier probe team. So these are the anti-Sikh riots which took place especially in Delhi and all across the country after assassination of Indira Gandhi by her Sikh bodyguards. And that was after the Operation Blue Star in Amritsar, in the Golden Temple, when battle tanks were entered into the sacred premises to bring down the terrorist hold in there, Jarnail Singh Bhindranwale. On page 7 you have 16 seismometers defunct in earthquake prone zones. So this is a study which shows that at least 20 of 35 seismometers in Maharashtra are lying in a state of disrepair, and 16 of these are located in seismic zone 3 and 4. So only 1 in 13 accelerographs are working across the state. So all this has been put forth, on which the government engineer here says, superintendent engineer, that we are planning to induct new instruments to measure intensity of earthquake now. On page 9 you have Uddhav stays work on RA metro shed. So this is regarding the RA forest. Here 2500 trees were cut down for construction of a metro car shed. So this project has now been stayed by the recently sworn in Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray. He has ordered stay on the construction, and he has said not a single leaf of RA will be cut now, and the entire project would be reviewed, and then the decision would be taken. It was also BJP and former Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis who criticized the move, calling it unfortunate and real disincentive for investors who want to infuse capital into Mumbai's infrastructure. But Mr. Thackeray has clarified that the decision would be taken on the matter, and he's not against any infrastructure project and is not going to stall other infrastructure projects in Mumbai. Here you have warmer winter likely this year, Indian Meteorological Department. So northernmost parts are likely to be an exception. So winter overall in the country on an average will be warmer than average. And this is a forecast by Indian Meteorological Department. It says average minimum temperature will be warmer than average across most of India. And this is DRDO defends NAG missiles. So this is the anti-tank guided missile, the indigenously built state-of-the-art missile NAG. So it is in advanced stages of development, and DRDO has said in a sharp response to statements that raised questions on the program that this is a man-portable anti-tank guided missile. So this is also in an advanced stage of trials. So the statement on the test firing issued by a public relations firm on behalf of spike manufacturer Rafael Advanced Defense System said that it with the confidence in the missile established that Indian Army may need to revisit their plans for third generation missiles. So this is the statement on which the DRDO has responded. So this is spike. Spike is the anti-tank guided missile from Rafael. So though we are purchasing anti-tank guided missiles from outside the country, we are also indigenously developing them. So this is what DRDO has responded to, that these are in advanced stages of development and we may not need to revisit, as has been said by Rafael. It's Rafael, it was a public relations firm who spoke on behalf of Rafael, the manufacturer of Spike ATGM. So here you can see the statement says that both DRDO ATGM program as well as invitation to Indian industry to develop third generation missile will need a rethink, as having a fourth generation missile will put the plan for development of third generation missile questionable. So Spike LR is a fourth generation anti-tank guided missile. And so we are procuring that, test firing that, and we already have third generation missile still under development. So this is what the criticism was. On the editorial page, the first editorial is changing the spikes. So this is regarding Maharashtra's newly formed government. It says Maharashtra has a strange mix of parties in power, but that need not derail governance. So we have seen how a coalition of MNS, Congress and NCP has been formed in Maharashtra, with Uddhav Thackeray sworn in as the chief minister. And this is bringing back treasures. So this is regarding cultural artifacts, idols which have been stolen from India. And now we had seen in news how Australia said that it would be bringing back the Dwarpals and Ragraj in Jan 2020 when the Australian Prime Minister will be on a visit to India. So this editorial says that India needs to plug loopholes in legislation and enforcement to protect its cultural artifacts. So what steps need to be taken to ensure that such incidents do not take place again? So it is the kingpin Subhash Kapoor, who has allegedly been involved in illicit trade of antiquities at a global scale. He is presently behind bars in Tamil Nadu. The lead article, a political turning point or a pause. So this is regarding political developments in Maharashtra. So it says BJP's Maharashtra fiasco may not be interpreted as a setback to Modi government's stealthy way of operations. And this is getting organ donation to tick again. So this is regarding how the trust gap and inequality needs to be addressed, because it is impacting family consent for organ donation, which is crucial. It's like how, you know, altruism has been undermined and concerns are being raised by families after the death of a patient, and you know, that of a person, and how the body can be donated, organ can be donated. So organ donation needs to be given a boost. So the trust gap, inequalities need to be addressed. Then on the op-ed page you have shifting sands in Andhra Pradesh. So this on Saturdays is the ground zero coverage. So here it is in Andhra Pradesh, where the previous government had scrapped the free sand policy. So this free sand policy had actually boosted the mining mafia. So now Jagmohan Reddy government is attempting to regulate sand mining with a new policy. So industry and environmental activists have largely welcomed it, but there are concerns. So this is a sand mining issue which is covered here. So sand, it is required generally in construction industry and other such industries. So this sand mining takes place whether it is regulated, whether it is free, or whether, you know, it is charged whether it is allowed or not. So these are the concerns. So free sand mining policy has been scrapped, and now the new government in Andhra Pradesh is going to regulate sand mining and will bring in a new policy. Then on page 12 you have economy hit by climate of fear. So this is what Manmohan Singh has given a statement on the sharp slowdown in growth, on GDP growth plunging to 4.5% as we saw on the front page. And this is Bill to Amend Arms Act tabled in Lok Sabha. So Union Minister of State for Home Affairs has introduced a bill in the Lok Sabha that seeks to enhance the punishment for illegally possessing and making prohibited arms. So the Arms Act prescribes a person can have a maximum of 2 licensed firearms and will have to deposit the third one. Presently it is allowed, but after this bill is passed, third one has to be deposited with authorities or authorized gun dealers for de-licensing within 90 days of Parliament processing the passing the amended act. And this is Rajya Sabha members seek greater autonomy for states. So this is Rajya Sabha member Vaiku, who has moved a resolution to do away with the post of governor. So governor post has been controversial. It's an important issue. So this is that. Below you have JJP gets state party status. So Election Commission has granted Jananayak Janata Party the status of a recognized state party and the symbol of key in Haryana. So this Jananayak Janata Party was formed in December 2018 as a breakaway faction of INLD, Indian National Lokdal, and it won 10 seats in the recent Haryana Assembly elections. So it qualifies to become a state party now. And this is plea to stay electoral bond scheme. So the petition has been filed in the Supreme Court seeking stay, means stopping the implementation of the electoral bond scheme of 2018, saying that it has opened the floodgates of unlimited corporate donations to political parties and anonymous financing by Indian and foreign companies that can have serious repercussions on democracy. On international page you have Trump visits Afghanistan, says US Taliban talks back on track. So he celebrated Thanksgiving holiday with troops in Afghanistan during a surprise visit here. So now again US Taliban talks, which were abruptly stopped by President Donald Trump after Taliban attack, terrorist attack in Afghanistan. So now he's back on talks. And this is Sudan overturns moral policing law. So the transitional government dissolves al-Bashir's former ruling party. So Sudan government has overturned a moral policing law that criminalized wearing revealing clothes and drinking alcohol, and dissolved the country's former ruling party, fulfilling 2 key demands of pro-democracy protesters in Sudan. On business page you have recognize real fiscal deficit, put cash in people's hand. So this is what economists say, that non-government sector is in a tailspin and government needs to realize problem is on demand side and conduct expenditures to prop it up. So this is what has been suggested. And here you have SEBI asks to review ban on curvy using clients' POAs. So Securities Appellate Tribunal, the body to which appeals from SEBI go. So SAT has directed SEBI to reconsider its order restraining curvy stockbroking from using its clients' power of attorneys. So the regulator's decision to debar the brokerage from using power of attorneys was part of an ex parte order issued to barring the brokerage from taking new broking clients, as it had misused the client's securities for its own benefits. But SAT is asking it to review the ban. And here you have Reserve Bank files insolvency plea against Diwan Housing. So this is the first instance of insolvency and bankruptcy code been applied to a financial services firm. So Diwan Housing and Finance Corporation Limited has been referred to insolvency and bankruptcy under insolvency and bankruptcy code to NCLT, National Company Law Tribunal. And this is core sector contracts. So coal and electricity have dragged the index down, and core sector growth has contracted for second consecutive month by 5.8% in October 2019. And especially it is, as it says, due to coal and electricity. So you should know about these eight core sectors. So there is this index of eight core sectors too, which are also part of IIP, Index of Industrial Production. So these eight core sectors have contracted. The eight core sectors, two are already mentioned here. You can see coal and electricity. The other sectors also you should know. Here, crude oil. Then you have natural gas. Then you have refinery products. Then fertilizers, steel, cement, and so on. So that is it. Then the last page has sports related news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.